A miner should always be thinking about mining. Takes up a lot of power, so you want, you'd have to be very brave to try mining. If you'll be going with Nvidia, make sure you get the. What's up, internet? Uso ulit yung cryptocurrency, so we've gotten a lot of requests in the shop for miners. This video will talk about three kinds of miners: ASIC miner, dedicated desktop miner, and on-the-side desktop mining. My first piece of advice is don't build a miner. I'll explain after the ad break.
What's up, internet? Mahirap pa rin makakuha ng PC parts ngayon, but that doesn't mean you can't get this shirt to remind you of what you still need. Jokes aside, na totoo naman, we made our very first merch to not only reflect our passion for PC building, but to help you teach your friends what you know through the Hardware Sugar PC Anatomy shirt.
To order, go to our site or click on the link in the video description. Hover over products and select t-shirts. We have three designs and they come in sizes ranging from small to XL. Press add to cart, select your delivery option, and your payment terms. We deliver anywhere in the Philippines, but you can save on the delivery fee by paying and picking it up in our store in Makati.
And if you wear it long enough, baka maswertehan ka, and you'll finally get the go signal from your significant other or your parents to finally get that AIO or RTX 3080 that you've been dying for.
The first thing to ask yourself is, what will you be mining? If you'll be mining Bitcoin, the OG cryptocurrency which has the most name recognition, then don't build a miner. Any desktop computer is very inefficient to mine Bitcoin. It's like if you wanted to dig a hole 5 feet deep but the only thing you had to dig with was a toothpick. Ganun kalala. Yes, kahit 3090 gamitin mo, hindi pa rin siya cost efficient. For BTC mining, you need specialized machines called ASIC miners. They've been specifically designed to mine Bitcoin and to do nothing else. You can't play games on them, you can't browse with them. These machines only have one purpose, to mine Bitcoin. You can find ASIC miners on Lazada, but I don't have a personal go-to seller to recommend. Unfortunately, Hardware Sugar does not sell ASIC miners. If that's something you want, baka kailangan mo kausapin yung mga may-ari. Now, if you'll be mining a different currency, let's say Ethereum, that's a different story. You can build a dedicated miner using desktop components. Here's what you need for a cost-efficient miner. CPU, get the cheapest. It doesn't need to be fast. Basically, it will only be running the OS. Same goes for RAM and storage. You can go cheap on those components. Case. A lot of professional miners just leave their cards outside, so no case, no enclosure. This helps with airflow and to dissipate heat quickly. The neater miners have custom frames built so you can suspend the cards in the air and link them via riser cable to the MOBO. You will need riser cables. You want as many cards as possible, but you can't physically cram the GPUs onto the motherboard. They need to be hanging in the air in a line. Then you attach the riser cable to the GPU. Then the riser cables will be the one to connect to the motherboard. The cables are much thinner, so there's more space. They can be accommodated on the board. So the GPUs are suspended either on top or on the side of the case, and then the riser cables are what bridge the MOBO and the GPUs. For the motherboard, you want one with as many PCIe slots as possible because you want to be running as many GPUs as possible on one system. Manufacturers have come out with dedicated mining boards. You can get something like this, which already features onboard graphics, onboard CPU, and 8 PCIe slots. The record I think I've seen from a more well-known manufacturer is this one from ASRock with 13 PCIe slots. Mining takes up a lot of power, so you want the best possible PSU that you can get. Back when I was mining a couple of years ago, my PSU was a 1200-watt EVGA 80+ Platinum PSU. Again, some brands have dedicated mining PSUs, but you can also use the high-end PSUs from the usual manufacturers. Finally, the core of any mining machine is composed of lots and lots of GPUs. If you're going AMD, the 6600 XT or 6700 XT are pretty good value for your money. We do have a dedicated miner who's a regular customer in the shop, and he's bought a lot of those two cards in particular, and he's showing pretty good cost-efficient performance from them. If you'll be going with Nvidia, make sure you get the non-LHR or non-low hash rate cards. What's LHR? For the 3000 series, Nvidia deliberately hobbled their cards for mining. That's the LHR version. They put a hard cap on the speed that the cards can do for mining. So LHR cards suck for mining but are still fast for everything else. Nvidia has mentioned that the 3090 will always be non-LHR, but for the other 3000 series cards, it's becoming more and more difficult to find non-LHR. So do check before buying. Of course, miners are smart guys and they've already come up with workarounds. So we suggest if you're starting and you want Nvidia cards, just get non-LHR. Once you've established your miner, then that's the time maybe pick up an LHR card or two to play around with and to see how efficient the workarounds are. So yun na yun, that's a dedicated desktop miner. Go cheap on the CPU, RAM, and storage. Splurge on the PSU, motherboard, and especially GPUs. The last is a part-time miner. A lot of people who buy high-end rigs for gaming and editing think na why not try kaya natin yung mining. Total, high-end na rin rig ko, I might as well try to earn some money from it. And it's true, high-end rigs are good candidates for sideline or part-time mining because they already have the most important part of the miner, a very fast GPU, assuming non-LHR if it's an Nvidia card. Mining does create a lot of heat, so if you're building a PC to be also used as a part-time miner, get one of the large cases with good airflow. We recommend the Fractal Design Torrent or the Fractal Design Meshify 2 because you really want a lot of air moving through your case. That GPU is gonna be pumping out a lot of heat when it's mining. The cases I mentioned are quite large because they do have good airflow. You'd have to be very brave to try mining on a typical ITX build. Aside from the case and GPU, most high-end rigs will already have a good PSU, which is sufficient to run the GPU, so even on that front, you're already covered. Warning though, part-time mining can be very addicting. At first, you start out with, oh, I'll just mine when I'm not at my computer. Then the next thing is, oh, I'll mine even at night. The next thing you know, 24/7, you're not using your computer for gaming, for editing, you're not enjoying it. All it's doing is mining. So it's a slippery slope. It's very addictive, especially when you start seeing the profits come in. Since money is involved, spending it, making it, a miner should always be thinking about one thing, the bottom line. What's the most cost-efficient way to build and run my miner? So for CapEx or capital expenditures, that would be your hardware. What's the cheapest hardware I need to get the best miner? Your OPEX or operating expenses would be your electricity. What's the least amount of voltage I can feed into my cards and still get a very good hash rate or mining speed? A lot of the art of mining is in undervolting your cards. So feeding them just the right amount of electricity so you don't waste your money on energy you don't need while still generating good hash rates. Mining is an expensive pursuit, so do think about it and crunch the numbers before you decide to jump into it. Thanks for watching. And thank you to our top fans. Na-afford na namin itong upuan na to. Hindi, joke lang. Thank you to Lia Magnaye, Ian Meru, Richard Onkinko, ITX Addict, John Ruben Ocha, Christian Espinosa, and Rafael James. Thank you for supporting the channel.